Hi, my name is Al Hussein Barry. Welcome to this lesson on the theory of costs. This lesson is part of a series on the economics for the West African Senior School Certificate Examination, commonly known as the WASSCE. Today, we are going to turn our attention to the theory of costs. And the first lesson in this series is the introduction to the nature and theory of costs in economics and how it relates to the theory of production. You shall be hearing a lot of new words we shall be coming to just now. But first of all, I just wanted to note the importance of costs, the reason why we study costs. As you can see, in economics, the primary goal of firms is to make profit. Okay, this is the working assumption that firms, businesses are out to make profit. Of course, there may be other reasons, but this is the working definition, right? And profit actually equals the revenue, that is, when you sell, whatever it is you sell, the amount of money you get. So profit is equal to the revenue minus the costs. So what remains at the end of the day in the hand of a businessman or an entrepreneur is the profit. Okay, and this profit depends on revenue, that is what you gain from selling, minus and your costs, what it costs you to produce the good or service you are producing. So this is why studying cost is extremely important in economics. So today we are just going to have a brief introduction to the nature of cost. So the key objectives here will be looking at the term cost and what this means in economists, as opposed to how accountants would use the term cost. We shall be looking at some of the key assumptions we use in the theory of costs. Basically, the common economic assumption of ceteris paribus, which means holding other things constant, and the assumption that the business owner, say my friend Adama here, is getting her factors of production. She's buying the raw materials for production in a competitive market. Okay. Where there are many sellers, many buyers, the good is normally homogeneous, all those things that we look at when we come to market structures. We shall also be looking at the relationship between the theory of production and the theory of costs very quickly and differentiate between costs in the short run, costs in the long run. Okay, but before we do all of that, why don't we quickly just a quick look at some of the vocabulary you'll be learning today. And also before doing that, see here in economics, the quantity of output that is produced actually depends on capital and labor. What we do normally is we try to class all factors of production into two major types. Okay, so capital, maybe things like building, utensils, machinery that you use. So for my friend Adama here, maybe the freezer, the electric the gas she's using for cooking and preparing the food in the restaurant, okay? And the labor might be the people she hires to work in the restaurant, okay? So we class the factors of production into two major categories, capital and labor. So output, that is the quantity, say for example, of plates she can produce, depends on the quantities of capital and labor she's using in her restaurant. Okay, so let me just get rid of that quickly. Some of the words you might hear as we go through this lesson, some new vocabulary will include words such as marginal cost. You'll be hearing things like marginal cost. You'll be hearing words like variable cost. You'll be hearing things like short run, okay, long run. Right, you'll be hearing terms such as average variable cost, fixed costs. You'll be hearing terms such as sunk cost. Right, so these are all words we'll be seeing as we go through this lesson. Of course, we shall be looking at the term cost, especially as how it is used in economics. Right, so these are common words you'd see. Marginal cost here has to do with extra cost, okay? So extra, this is what the margin, okay? Variable cost, variable here means cost that change, the cost that vary. Vary means to change, okay? Fixed costs are costs that do not change with the level of output. So whether or not my friend Adama here produces 10 plates or 50 plates, these types of costs will not change. For example, say she pays rent for where she is having her restaurant. So things like rent will be fixed cost. Things like maybe she took a loan from a microcredit organization. So loan repayments, those are all fixed cost. They do not change depending on the level of output she's producing. Okay. These are different from what we call sunk costs, which are just costs that you cannot recover. Okay. Say when my friend Adama starts her restaurant, she went out and made brochures. Okay, she went and did advertisement. The money she has paid for advertisement, money she has printed brochures, and a carpenter, she cannot recover those sorts of costs, right? So those are some costs, costs that you cannot do anything about anymore. And we have fixed costs, costs that do not change with the level of output, okay? Say maybe your electricity bills. Okay, if you pay a fixed amount every month of your electricity usage, it does not depend on the number of plates you produce. Okay, so that's an introduction to the vocabulary we shall be using in this lesson. Now, let us go on and look at the first section here, which is on. Let me get this. Cost. Okay, let us talk about cost. In economics, when you hear the term cost, this is actually not just the amount of money you are going to pay for something. What we actually refer to in economics when we talk about cost is actually opportunity cost. Opportunity cost, right? And this simply means in economics, the central problem we have is scarcity. Okay, we have limited resources. Resources are limited. Okay, but our wants are unlimited. Okay, so this is the central problem that economics tries to solve. How can we satisfy ourselves with the limited resources we have, given that our wants and needs are unlimited? Okay, for example, you have only 24 hours in a day, right? That is a limited resource. So time is a limited resource in this case. But you may want to, you have lots of desires for this time. You may want to study, you may want to go and play sports. Okay, you want to hang out with your friends. And a lot more other things you want to do with your time. Okay? Sorry about that. So this is the central problem. So the term cost then in economics. So what ends up happening normally is that people have to face trade-offs. You have to decide how much you want to study, because the number of hours you are going to spend studying, you cannot spend those same number of hours playing with your friends. So you have to face trade-offs. You have to choose. And in choosing, we have to face what we call opportunity costs. Okay, so the opportunity cost actually refers to the value of an activity given the alternatives that are possible. Say, for example, studying for 1 hour gives you a benefit of say 20 units of benefit. Okay, playing with your friends gives you say 15 units of benefit. So now the cost of studying or playing with your friends is actually the difference between the 20 units and the 15 units. So it's going to cost you 5 units. So this is the opportunity cost of playing with your friends. It is the extra amount you would have gotten if you had gone on to study, because studying benefits you 20 units of satisfaction. Okay, while playing with your friends benefits you 15 units of satisfaction. Okay, so this is the central meaning of costs in economics.